Don't you all know this? I'm gonna poop in here.
Come on,
look at me. I'm gonna poop in here. I'm gonna poop inside here. I'm not kidding. I'm not threatening you.
No. Do it right here. You gotta go. Do it right here.
I'm not threatening you, car.
No.
This was the moment a prisoner tricked the police to escape prison, and it's just one of many similar cases, starting with the most insane prisoner escape you'll see on the internet. On July 15th, 2023, officers responded to multiple reports of a suspicious individual lurking around residents' backyards. What they were unaware of is that this individual was not only highly dangerous, but also adept at deception.
You went out for a jog?
Yeah, I jog all the time, yeah.
Dressed like that?
Yep. Oh, yeah.
The hoodie and like you're wearing dress pants and like loafers.
These are my running shoes actually.
Seriously?
Yes.
What's your first name? You look familiar.
Wes Anderson.
What's your last name?
Anderson.
And Wes Anderson. Yeah. Why do you look familiar?
You watch Fordham? I fought professionally for a little bit.
Do you have a warrant?
The
police finally began to ask a serious question as the officers ran a background check on him. It turned out that he had an extensive list of active arrest warrants across various countries for offenses including assault, drug charges, and violations of court orders. He was initially transported to the hospital for a medical evaluation. He was then transferred to jail upon his release. However, as he made the transition from hospital to jail, he began to pull some funny stunts, and it was at this point things started to get interesting.
Wes, I don't want you to take a crap here. I really don't.
No, stop.
No, that's this. Did you leave it down or up? Because you're going to have to clean it up anyway, so. Did you leave it down or up?
Dude, like I said, we would have been halfway to
jail. Hey, up or down? Right. Up or down? Up? You sure?
Okay.
Up higher?
Turn around.
Yeah,
We're going to put it.
How'd you break your collarbone?
He convinced the officers to use multiple handcuffs, marking just one of the numerous errors these inexperienced cops would commit.
You all know this. I'm gonna poop in here.
Look at me.
I'm gonna poop in here. I'm gonna poop inside here. I'm not kidding. I'm not threatening you. I'm not being a dick. I'm gonna shit inside here. You're gonna humiliate me. It's a fucking moron. Thank you.
No reason to humiliate you.
As he was being transported to jail in the police patrol car, the suspect maneuvered his handcuffs to the front and threatened to use the vehicle as a restroom, compelling the officers to make an emergency stop on a busy expressway. Unknown to them at the time, this was all orchestrated as part of the suspect's plan to escape.
What's wrong? Why are you trying to put your hands in the front?
I'm gonna get off my foot.
Stop it, man! Listen, can you notify state and get us a unit? We are northbound on 294, come up to Lakewood Road. Our prisoner got his handcuffs in front. He's acting erratically. Hold on, man! Listen, stop! I'm pulling over!
Alright,
hold on. Come here, grab him. You got fucking
open the fucking door, you fucking shit.
Come on.
Hey, your mask. Give me something to wipe my fucking ass.
Come on.
Give me something to wipe my ass with that turd taking off my ass. Give me a fucking glove. Give me that fucking glove so I can wipe my asshole.
Do you have keys on you?
Give me the fucking glove.
Hold on. Watch it, Rick.
Here.
Now get out of the car, Lowe. Right here. Get out of the car. Do it over here.
Trying to shit.
Huh?
His plan seemed to be working as the officers parked on a busy expressway, permitting him to relieve himself, but it didn't stop there.
Shit out of there, dude.
You good?
I'm not going back in there.
Huh?
I'm not going back in there, shit. I'm not going to sit in the shit, clean the shit out. Right?
I ain't cleaning the shit out.
Cool, I don't want to either.
Okay, turn around baseball. Come on.
Do it clean.
Just chill out, okay?
I chill out, man.
Okay, chill out.
I'm in handcuffs. Can't do much. Yeah. You ready? You stand back?
No. 113, emergency. Taser deployed. Suspect is going southbound in traffic. Oh, he just carjacked somebody in a maroon GMC van.
He could definitely run as fast as he talks. With handcuffs still on, he outran the pursuing officers, leaving them to play catch up. Now, the two officers had to meet with their superior and explain what happened.
What the fuck happened? So, he was playing, I gotta piss right before the time to go. So we let him piss, and then it was, I got chest pains. We're like, dude, they did a lot of shit. You're good. So then it was, the doctor's gonna humor him. Put him in the wheelchair, she wants to see while you're sitting in the chair.
The officer then turned off the body cam. Meanwhile, the suspect, who had carjacked a commuter's vehicle, later abandoned the stolen red van, and then carjacked a Camaro. This decision would ultimately seal his fate. The suspect proceeded to drive from Illinois all the way to Wisconsin. Police soon spotted him, initiating a tense and exciting car chase. He seemed to be having fun as he effortlessly evaded the spikes and booby traps set by the officers. However, after some time, the car began to slow down, not because he was giving up, but unknown to him, the car was equipped with an OnStar feature, allowing it to be remotely deactivated. This deactivation ensured Wesley's inevitable apprehension.
Stop it.
Make it clear. Danny Moore, hang on. If you reach for anything, you're going to... You understand?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Why are you pointing your gun at me, please? We're okay. Easy. It's this close, sir?
Let me see your other hand. Let's see your hands.
My hands are right here, sir.
Okay.
Please do not taste me. Shoot me. Please don't cut on my face.
Somebody got a scissors. We can cut that belt and yank him out.
Don't hit me, guys.
Down on the ground.
Please don't hit me.
Kenosha police officers clearly had no time for his games. He was arrested and charged with first-degree reckless endangerment, assaulting an officer, attempting to disarm an officer, fleeing from an officer, unauthorized vehicle operation, and numerous outstanding felony warrants. You might consider this prisoner exceptionally clever, but wait until you meet the next criminal, who went so far as to deceive a cop into helping him in stealing a car. Police officers responded to a call after a neighbor reported two men lurking around, peeping into people's cars. Upon arrival, officers spotted a shirtless man wearing shorts in a house garage.
You got a call because somebody's going to make a phone call. Is this your vehicle?
Maintaining near-perfect composure, he swiftly removed his shirt upon spotting the cops, portraying the scene as if he was the homeowner and had been awakened from sleep by the officers. And the officer's subsequent request would further assist him in executing his plan.
Take a look in the truck and see if it... Okay, doors are open.
Mistakenly convinced that the criminal was the homeowner, they requested him to inspect his truck for any missing items. The truck turned out not to be locked this whole time, so he effortlessly opened the truck door without keys. Furthermore, when the officer requested identification, it only served to further work in his favor.
You have some ID on you?
He made a run for it while the officer assumed he had gone indoors to retrieve his ID. After waiting for some time, they realized the man was the criminal they were searching for, and he had successfully fled. Later, once the officers had cleared the scene, the same suspect returned and stole the unlocked truck, managing to escape once again. If you're enjoying the video so far, please don't forget to like and subscribe. It's difficult to determine whether the prisoner was too smart or if the cops were simply too naive. However, the next prisoner is undeniably a genius, as there was no way the cop could tell that he's a prisoner.
What is? We got an escapee.
Oh, shit. I promise you, I'm not no damn prison escapee.
You'd have done run by now. You know that yourself. Yeah. You'd have done run by now.
On May 4th, 2006, the entire Pollock area was placed on lockdown by the police following the escape of a convicted felon, Richard Lee McNair, who had previously managed to escape twice. He was spotted by an officer, a moment that would typically signify the end of an escape. But watch how this remarkably smart inmate convinced the cop to let him go.
You live around here, buddy?
No.
Where do you live at?
Down the road by Pineville. Uh-huh.
Okay. Do you have any form of identification on you?
No, man.
What's your name?
Robert Jones.
Robert Jones?
Uh-huh. Why, I'm not supposed to be on the tracks?
No, that's not the problem right now. What's your address?
I don't have an address. I'm at the hotel. We're working on houses and stuff. I got the roofing.
Roofing?
Yep.
Okay.
for my brother.
Alright. What it is, we got an escapee.
Oh, shit. Where from?
Prison.
There's a prison here?
Yeah.
Man, it is hot.
The suspects provided the officer with the name Robert Jones, a detail that would prove significant later in their interaction. The officer proceeded to radio dispatch to obtain a description of the escapee, aiming to confirm whether he wasn't making a huge mistake.
Hey, this call. Subject wore glasses? Nothing about glasses. Can you find out? I'm out with a white male on the tracks at Gilly Williams.
You can call my little brother.
What about? Take your glove off. Any tattoos or anything? Flip it over. No, just... No, he's clean.
I don't know. Jesus. I'm 50 years old.
How old is your guy? You're how old?
50. I was born in 56.
He was born in 56. 58. Any kind of details you can give me, huh? What color you got?
Green, well, kind of a turquoise blue.
Turquoise blue?
Yeah.
You want to give me some more?
Call my little brother, man.
Alright, let me just verify. He says his brother's staying at the motel. Let me verify that, and if so, I'll just cut him loose. Alright, thanks.
This inmate appeared well-prepared for the encounter, offering ready-made lies and responses to every question posed by the officer. This wasn't surprising, though, considering he had already been involved in two prior infamous escapes.
You know the bad thing about it?
What's that?
You're matching up to him.
Come on. Well, that sucks, doesn't it?
Yeah. Where are you staying at?
That Titusville. Little over.
Where's that at?
I don't even know the address. We just got into town about a week ago, and he dropped me off to jog. I always jog about 12 miles a day.
Where'd he drop you off at?
Up there on that road by, there's some construction going on up there, an alley.
Uh-huh.
And he dropped me off, and he'll be back to the hotel in about probably 10 minutes, 15 minutes.
Who do y'all work for?
It's his.
I know. What's the name of the company?
Fields Roofing.
Okay.
Fields Roofing.
Did you go through a briar patch or something?
Well, yeah, roofing. I always roof in shorts and cut my scratching up on, the roofing.
That's
stuff.
Why your knees are all cut up?
Yeah.
Or y'all got pads?
Huh?
Y'all wear pads?
Hell no, too hot. They rub the pads rub your back of your legs and stuff.
Where are you from?
Huh? Where originally? Dallas, Texas.
I mean, that's where y'all stay
at? That's where we're
out of. Out of Dallas, Texas? Yes, what's your name again?
Jimmy Jones.
The prisoner finally slipped up when he told the officer his name was Jimmy Jones, contradicting the earlier mention of Robert Jones, some genius. Strangely, the officer failed to notice the inconsistency.
Put yourself in my position.
Well, yeah, but I'm not.
I know. I'm not
you
throwing you against
them.
Hey, you wouldn't believe what them guys do.
Okay.
I mean, they got years and years to think about how they're going to do it. Now, when I crossed the tracks down there, I saw you running. I said, well, how lucky can I be?
No. I'm not no prison escapee. I promise you, I'm not no damn prison escapee.
You'd have done run by now. You know that yourself. Yeah. You'd have done run by now.
His composed demeanor seemed to convince the officers that he couldn't possibly be the escaped inmate. Given his flawless performance during the interrogation, what unfolded next was hardly surprising.
I'm sorry to have to hold you up, but...
Hey, no, I'm just doing my job, man.
I know you are.
But, just be careful. You'll probably get stopped again, okay? Don't be alarmed by it.
Borderline,
yeah.
Okay, and you'll be on until, this shift...
I'll be on until we find this on the gun. They'll just stop you for a minute, check you out and everything. But if you do jog again in the future, carry some ID with you.
See, I'm sorry. When I was in the military, we never carried our ID on base and stuff.
On base is different.
Yeah, I know.
You know, they assure you if you can cross on, you got something.
Yep.
But out here, you're in civilian life, you know.
Were you in the military?
No, I wasn't.
I'm retired Army.
But, in the future, if you're going to jog again, that way, I mean, if you get run over by a train, I know who you are. I don't have to start second-guessing who he is, you know.
Can you write down your phone number, your cell phone number, so I can have whoever call you?
Just call. You got a cell phone with you?
No, hell no. I don't even have a cell phone or anything.
Just call 911 is all you got to do, and they'll get a hold to us.
Okay.
All right.
That's our quick line there.
You have a good day now.
Be careful, buddy.
Thank you.
All right.
This was the last sighting of Richard for the next 18 months. However, in October 2007, Richard was apprehended in New Brunswick after being identified driving a stolen vehicle. The next prisoner outsmarted the cops to such an extent that they actually ended up giving him a ride out of jail. On May 1st, 2017, Santa Fe sheriff deputies were summoned when a man was observed walking barefoot on the highway.
You don't want to come back into Santa Fe? We can bring you in this way.
The officers offered to give him a ride to the city, but what the officers didn't know yet was that this is 30-year-old Raymond Lopez, who had just escaped from the nearby New Mexico penitentiary by simply opening a door and jumping the fence. During the ride to a shelter to get Raymond's shoes, his luck seemed to run out as something unexpected happened.
Oh man, they just put out an alarm that somebody either escaped from the jail or escaped from the prison. That's not you.
Despite his denial, Raymond was eventually identified as the escapee, fitting the description perfectly. He was subsequently returned to prison and faced additional charges of lying to an officer and escaping from prison. The next suspect took evading the police to an unprecedented level. On March 7th, 2022, Pulaski Sheriff deputies were transporting inmate Joel Sanchez Delgado, who was confined to a wheelchair, to court in Arkansas to face charges for his crimes. Delgado had claimed to have sustained injuries during his arrests.
What do you say, OJ?
Hey, you see a shoe back there? Where is it?
Moments away from entering the courthouse, the officer's attention was briefly diverted, and that's when Delgado striked.
Oh, I'm gonna catch you, baby. I'm gonna shoot your bitch head. I ain't got my radio. Hey, can you call the police for me? Call the police for me. Hey, call the police. Call the police. Which way it go? Hey, bro. Let me, which way it go? Nah, which way it go?
We're straight through the alley. Cut that way.
What's your phone? My damn radio came.
Hold on.
The suspect not only miraculously appeared to be healed, but he also managed to outrun the officer, revealing that his supposed injuries were never real. The officer found himself at a disadvantage as he wasn't with his radio to call for backup.
Hello? Hey, huh? The wheelchair dude got up and ran. Yeah. I couldn't catch his ass, and my radio was in the mother. I had my camera on, though. The wheelchair dude. I couldn't catch him, hell. Teams had pulled off. Yeah. I can't even remember his name. He on the run.
He eventually managed to call for backup using a passerby's phone, but by then, Delgado was long gone. Hours later, the police apprehended Delgado, who now faced an additional charge of third-degree escape. You can call him Professor X Convict. The next case isn't just the toughest, it's the most epic. This escapee managed to elude the police for over 2 weeks. Watch how he did it. On April 29th, 2022, Casey White, an inmate at Lauderdale County Jail awaiting trial for a capital murder case, escaped with the assistance of his lover, Warden Vicky White. Despite not being related, Vicky fell deeply in love, opened the prison doors for Casey, and together they fled in a stolen car. After being on the run for 11 days, U.S. Marshals finally tracked them down in Indiana. During a car pursuit initiated by authorities, an accidental 911 call revealed Casey and Vicky arguing.
Amazon Island. 911. Hello?
Everybody's going on. Let's get out. Run.
Vicky appeared scared and asked Casey to stop the car before they both got killed, but moments after, gunshots were heard, where Vicky was said to have shot herself in the head. Moments later, U.S. Marshals rammed into their car, rendering it immobile, and they quickly subdue the suspects. With Casey secured, the officers quickly tend to Vicky in an attempt to save her life.
Yes, still breathing. Would it be better if we try to pull the vehicle back? Would it be safer?
She was rushed to the hospital, where she later succumbed to her injuries. Meanwhile, Casey was transferred to a maximum security prison, where he faced additional charges for the prison break. If you enjoy videos like this, please like, subscribe, and watch this one.